Today, I'm going to prepare risotto al parmigiano and try to understand why Thermomix does it so well. My name is Stefano, welcome to my channel. If you like the video, you already know what to do. A few months ago, out of pure curiosity, I tried a very simple risotto parmesan with Thermomix. The result was amazing. Even though I had made millions in my career, that was one of the best. In this video, I'm going to analyze why. If we can understand the crucial steps, we will be able to have the same result even without Thermomix. But let's start with the basics, preparing the chicken broth. A good broth is essential for the success of the risotto. Make it simple, tasty, and simmer for 3-4 hours. The great thing about Thermomix is that it can do almost everything. For example, grating 40 grams of parmesan. But also things that are not exactly perfect, such as chopping 30 grams of onion, better done with a knife. At this point, add oil and butter. I only added butter as I don't like mixing butter and oil together, but that's completely up to you. Then cook for 3 minutes for what in Italia is called soffritto, which will add flavor to the risotto, but also a bit of heaviness. For example, at the restaurant where I work, I usually skip this step to get a lighter and more elegant result. We therefore arrive to the first fundamental step. In Italia it's called tostare, or toasting in English. Regarding the rice to be used, there are various types of Italian rice, which have different quality and properties. The most popular are Carnaroli, Vialone Nano, or Arborio, as in my case. Pay attention to the cooking time that is always indicated in the packaging. Different kind of rice has different kind of cooking time. This type of rice have the characteristic of containing a high content of starches, which are mainly responsible for giving creaminess to the risotto. Thermomix will toast the rice for 3 minutes at 120 degrees, which is the ideal temperature and time for this type of application. The starches on the surface of the grain will react with the temperature, producing various effects, especially some delicious toasted aroma and a structural change of the surface that will slow down the release of starch. Usually, when it is well toasted, the rice will become whiter and almost translucent. Be careful not to burn it. That will be the right time to add white wine, better if cold, which will lower the temperature and give an acidic touch, which is always recommended in a risotto. So 1 minute at 100 degrees. Here is the risotto after the white wine. At this point, add 720 grams of boiling broth. I was really undecided on this, as in the classic procedure, you should add the boiling broth one liter at a time. But honestly, the result was perfect, so why change it? Add 10 grams salt. What the Thermomix does very well here is to keep the temperature constant and mix continuously without stopping, creating an amazing gel of starches. The temperature at which this application occurs is quite variable. It ranges from just under 70 degrees to over 80 degrees. Stirring constantly will ensure that this gel will not stick on the pot and will not be lost. During cooking, the rice will absorb a lot of liquid, and the exact amounts here depend too on many factors, not least the cooking level. On average, however, a cooked grain of rice contains at least 70% of liquid, which is why in Italy we eat rice al dente, which means with a hard and not completely cooked section on the center of the grain. If you go behind this point, you will have a more swollen grain and a texture that, in my opinion, is less interesting than a risotto with a light, crunchy bite. In my case, I stopped risotto al dente a minute earlier. The only step that Thermomix is not able to do is called mantecatura, which means whipping. It's the final step of risotto and is made out of the heat. Here I added 20 grams of butter, which is very little for 4 portions of risotto, and only later, when the temperature drops a little, 40 grams of the previously grated parmesan. Stir well in order to obtain an emulsion. Then I like to rest the risotto covered for a minute to lower the temperature around 65 degrees Celsius, which is the perfect temperature to enjoy risotto. Serve and taste it immediately, as Thermomix also recommends. The perfect risotto must be tasty, creamy, and light. The rice grain should be whole, not broken, and cooked to the point. Using Thermomix and following the various steps, you will truly get a perfect risotto with a sensational creaminess, without having to do basically anything. However, if you understand the steps, you can get the same result by doing it in a pot in a classic way. And that's all for today's video. If you find it useful, don't forget to click like, share it with your friends, consider subscribing, and I'll catch you guys in the next episode.